today I'm going to be listening to an interview done with Kurt Cobain by Jon Savage in July 22, 1993. And this was done on cassette tape. And I'm listening to specifically the blank on blank version of this interview. And I'm just going to be reacting to the interview with Kurt Cobain and seeing if there's anything of interest that we can gain about his songwriting process and the creative process in general. But today I'm going to be specifically talking about pain and songwriting and how Kurt Cobain uses pain to write music. I grew up in the 90s, and if you also spent time in that time period, then you know that Kurt Cobain was North America's grunge sweetheart. The songs that Kurt Cobain wrote were dirty, gritty, and yep, you guessed it, grungy. Nirvana described themselves in self-deprecating ways, using words like dirt, scum to refer to their music. In 1990, Nirvana consisted of only Kurt Cobain, the singer and guitarist, and bassist Chris Novoselic, and they were eventually introduced to Dave Grohl through the Melvins. And of course, they became a 90s grunge staple. By 1991, Nirvana was already pretty famous. They had reached number one on Billboard's Alternative Songs chart, with Pearl Jam closely following. And by this time, grunge went from just being a joke or sort of like a jokey way to describe their music to an actual musical genre. And grunge is a rock music subgenre, which is characterized by its heavy guitar distortion, feedback, and heartfelt, anguished lyrics. So what made Kurt Cobain's specific grunge stand out in terms of the way that Kurt Cobain expressed pain and sort of illustrated pain in a way that North America and actually international fans all around the world can really relate to? When you listen to a Kurt Cobain song, a Nirvana song, you really feel the pain. You not only observe it in the songwriting, but you get the sense that you can really, really feel it yourself. And I think this was pretty unique. And anyone who knows Kurt Cobain and is a fan of Nirvana knows that their music expressed pain. But let's take a listen to the interview with Kurt Cobain with Jon Savage and just see what we can glean from this interview. Let's take a listen.
Did you have problems in high school?
Yeah. You know, I felt so different and so crazy that people just left me alone. I always felt that they would vote me most likely to kill everyone at a high school dance, you know? My mother has always tried to keep a little bit of English culture in our family. Like, we drink tea all the time. We have tea, you know. Although I've never really known my ancestry. I didn't even know until this year that the name Cobain was Irish. I found out through different phone books throughout America. I couldn't find any Cobains at all, so I started calling Coburns. And I found this one lady in San Francisco, and she had been researching our family history. And we came from County Cork, which is a weird coincidence, because when we toured, we played in Cork. And the entire day, I walked around in a daze. I never felt more spiritual in my life. I was almost in tears the whole day. It was the weirdest thing. Sit and drink in a royal tea. I had a really good childhood until the divorce. And all of a sudden, my whole world changed. I couldn't face some of my friends at school. I desperately wanted to have the classic, typical family, mother, father.
Okay, so that was really interesting. Kurt Cobain says that he had a relatively good childhood until his parents got divorced. And at that point, he felt that he could no longer face his friends, his other classmates. And he kind of just wanted nothing more than to have the stereotypical everyday family that was together. I think something that is sort of overlooked is the idea that a divorce can be a traumatic life experience, because it is, it can be. Trauma is not just, you know, a violent event. It could be something that means a serious loss that seriously changed your life and affected the way that you experience the world. And I think that the divorce that Kurt Cobain went through can kind of be seen as a trauma. And so this is kind of like the first pain point that we get from Kurt, that he was experiencing pain at a young age through the loss of his family stability. And divorce also has other implications. For example, it could lead to poverty, etc. We don't know the full details necessarily, but it definitely affected him. I mean, he says so himself. And it led to this sense of being different or other than kids around him. So let's take a little listen again and see what else we can sort of glean from Kurt Cobain's interview. And I'll talk a bit more about how he uses pain in his songwriting more towards the end. So let's just keep listening.
I'm always in pain too, and that really adds to the anger in our music. It really does. Kind of grateful for it in a way.
Yeah. Maybe you're feeling a bit better. No.
Yeah, especially since I've been married and I've had a child, you know, within the last year. My whole mental state and my physical state has been just almost improved 100%. It's like I haven't felt this optimistic since right before the divorce, you know? Light my candles in the
days, 'cause I found God. Hey. Okay, so Kurt Cobain talks about how he felt a lot of anger politically and socially. He talks a bit about feminism and how he felt angry for women and their oppression and the way that women have been historically talked about in songs and music. And so I think that he was not only a person in pain, but he was a pretty angry person. And I think that it's interesting because anger is actually a natural and almost like a physiological response to pain, whether it's pain that we are experiencing, let's say someone has hurt us, or someone has hurt someone that we care about and we're angry because we want there to be some sort of justice or for things to be sort of set right. So it's important to note that anger is still a form of pain in some ways. But it's important to know that anger is not just something that comes from pain alone. It's usually triggered by a thought or something else. For example, if I am hurt by someone, I may have the thought that it's not fair or it's not right that they did this to me. And so that would be anger. But it's kind of the root cause is still pain. And sometimes people are angry when they don't want to feel their pain. So it's interesting that he talks quite a bit about anger as well. So let's listen a bit further and see what else we can gain.
It was the anger that I felt, the alienation.
Did you have problems with people thinking that you were gay?
Yeah, I even thought that I was gay. I thought that might be the solution to my problem. Although I never experimented with it, I had a gay friend, and then my mother wouldn't allow me to be friends with him anymore because, she's homophobic. It was real devastating because finally I found a male friend who I actually hugged and was affectionate to.
Okay, so that's another pain point that Kurt Cobain experienced, was that he had a male friend that he finally felt close to and comfortable with, because he'd previously mainly been friends with girls. but because his friend was gay and his mother was homophobic, she didn't want him to hang around. She didn't want Kurt Cobain to hang around his gay friend due to her homophobia. And this is a very painful thing for a child or for a young person to go through, to be told you can't spend time with someone, especially for something that this person can't change. This person can't change the fact that they're gay, and there's nothing wrong with being gay. But this is another sort of pain point that Kurt Cobain brings up.
Maybe you're feeling a bit better now.
Yeah, especially since I've been married and I've had a child, you know, within the last year. My whole mental state and my physical state has been just almost improved 100%. It's like I haven't felt this optimistic since right before the divorce, you know. Scoliosis and the weight of the guitar has made my back grow in this curvature, so it gives me a back pain all the time, you know. I'm always in pain too, and that really adds to the anger in our music.
Okay, so Kurt Cobain experienced a lot of pain, not just emotionally through the loss, through his divorce, through his issues with his mom being homophobic, but he was physically in pain. He experienced a lot of pain all around. Kurt Cobain had an irritated stomach, and the illness actually went undiagnosed, but some have speculated it was a combination of psychosomatic stress, potentially from experiencing a difficult childhood, but also some have speculated it may have been undiagnosed Crohn's or even celiac disease, just because the symptoms did seem to match. And Kurt Cobain also had back pain due to scoliosis, and this was made worse by frequently playing guitar. So Kurt Cobain himself has said that being in pain added to the angry sound of Nirvana's music, to the anger of Nirvana's music. So Cobain not only expressed pain effectively through his music, he did it pretty uniquely, actually, because he combined this sort of punk defiance with these really tasty pop hooks and melodies, almost like reminiscent of the Beatles, some have said. But at the same time, he was expressing a pretty rare vulnerability, and this was kind of a new thing in the early 90s, and this is what the 90s sort of brought back, as opposed to the 80s. The 80s were full of these, like, polished pop songs and, like, synths, and it sounded very perfected and polished, but the 90s brought back some of this sort of retro vulnerability and authenticity. And so we see that in Kurt Cobain's songwriting, which is very authentic and very much expressing his emotions in a very heartfelt way. And some would say in a very vulnerable way, because when you listen to Kurt Cobain's songwriting, it almost feels like an exposed nerve. You feel the intensity of the emotion and of the anger and pain. Kurt Cobain also used an abstract style of songwriting, which left the meanings of his songs up to our imaginations for the most part. And at the same time, Kurt Cobain's songwriting and vocal expression was very heartfelt. He really sought to express himself and find himself a voice, and I think he succeeded in doing so. And it's really sad and unfortunate that we lost him at such an early age. He was only 27 when he passed away, because I think that he had a very unique and heartfelt way of songwriting, which I would like to see more of in general in the music world. To me, it seems like music was a way for Kurt Cobain to escape the suffering and to find freedom from his pain. And it was an escape from the outside world as well. And in the music world, Kurt Cobain was free to do and play anything he wanted. And he did that in Nirvana. So he wrote the songs, which sounded very pained, but they provide relief to him and to the listeners as well, especially to those of us that could relate to his music. And as a kid growing up in the 90s with divorced parents, a difficult and poor childhood, I was one of those people that heavily related to Nirvana. I remember sitting in my mom's car, waiting for her to get groceries or whatever it was, and just blasting Nirvana on the radio or on a CD. And just feeling this like relief from my everyday life, from stresses of experiencing difficulties in childhood. And yeah, it really did provide pain relief. And as a songwriter in my own practice, I noticed that I'm often motivated and inspired by pain. And it's not necessarily that the topics of the songs that I write are about pain. It's more that I'm inspired to write when I do feel pain, or whether it's about a past trauma or a pain that me or someone else in my life is experiencing. My motivation or inspiration comes from a place of real pain. And it's interesting because the word Nirvana actually means freedom from pain, suffering, and the external world. So I think that Kurt Cobain used songwriting to experience Nirvana or freedom from suffering. And I find that really interesting. And even though it is sad that he was experiencing so much pain and ultimately he wasn't able to find relief and to find a resolution to his pain, I think that his music still brings pain relief to many around the world today. And that's a really interesting thing. And Kurt Cobain said, "Punk is musical freedom. It's saying, doing, and playing what you want. In Webster's terms, Nirvana means freedom from pain, suffering, and the external world." And that's pretty close to my definition of punk rock. I can't help but agree.